Hey guys, Heartcloud Productions here. The YouTuber named Tootsie Forever made a recent video called The Rise and Demise of Friendship is Magic. And a certain part of the video made me think of how a terrible decision has affected my favorite character, Thorax. What I am talking about is how he is labeled as a character who is a great character with a likable and dorky personality, has a purpose in the lore of Friendship is Magic, and how I grew attached to him despite the mixed opinions he gets on things I honestly don't understand. It's just another background character that is labeled as wasted potential as the writing staff doesn't expand him to be more complex. So I'm here to unleash my negative and optimistic thoughts about Thorax being labeled as wasted potential and how I can provide ideas to make him complex. But this isn't to shame the character itself because he's still my favorite character in the entire series, just like Tootsie Forever has said in his video of why he loves Thorax so much. But unfortunately, I can't ignore that he just deserves better in terms of more appearances and more of his purpose in the show. Let's get started on this somewhat negative discussion on why Thorax just deserves better and how I can improve this problem. Disclaimer, I'm only going to be talking about Thorax in the video. Other MLP characters that are labeled as wasted potential will or will not be mentioned because it'll make the video too long or I might not know much about them. But if characters that are labeled as wasted potential and do have purposes to interact with Thorax, then they'll be mentioned in this video. Tootsie Forever's final MLP video brought up small bits of Thorax not having a complex purpose in the show. And I honestly had to agree with that statement. I even commented on the video giving out my feelings towards Thorax being labeled as wasted potential, despite it barely even being related to the video itself. But you know how I am with Thorax and why I wanted to, like, unleash my feelings, how Thorax is just labeled as wasted potential as a whole. Thorax debuted as a cute nervous wreck in Season 6. As he just wants to be friends with the others to sustain himself, and after his debut, we don't see him again until the Season 6 finale, where he almost died from getting his love energy taken away, and after going through a metamorphosis, he became the new leader of the Changelings. Thorax in Season 7 is him trying to adjust himself to the new changes of being the leader, and to make the Changeling Hive a much better place, by getting some advice from a blue dragoness, and also having family issues with his elder broodmate. In Season 8, Thorax introduced his cute little protege to the School of Friendship and was caught into a conflict with the other authorities when their students went missing. In Season 9, Thorax scolded his protege for making the Changeling Hive go into a massive panic when she ran off without telling anybody. And he helped take down the three baddies in the last two-parter of the series. And that's all there is in terms of appearances from Thorax in the whole series, unfortunately. Just summarizing, Thorax's notable appearances that doesn't count cameos feels too little when he only has 10 appearances in the whole show, compared to everybody else that are important. I know other characters have lesser appearances than Thorax, but after Season 7, he just became one of those background characters that the viewers might forget about. If the show wants to treat Thorax like a big deal for the change of the Changeling lore, then he needs to be expanded more with his character, purpose, and the characters he interacts with. After his debut episode, I felt like the storyline would have continued to expand upon Thorax's short life at the Crystal Empire under the care of Shining Armor and Princess Cadence. Like how he earned the trust of a large crowd of ponies to be his friend, and get crystallized to the point where he gets his crystal wings. That way, the season 6 finale wouldn't feel like a big jump compared to his debut, to the point where it feels natural when he gets his crystal wings. And another episode of how he might have formed a bond with Flurryheart. The few cute fan art and fanfictions that I could find would have been a reality to giving a cute slice of life story of Thorax bonding with the Alicorn baby. It could give the little OP baby some depth to make her a little interesting and showcase how Thorax's crystal wings aren't making him starve for love energy anymore. The season 6 finale plays the same, but maybe foreshadow of the Changelings capturing the most powerful beings of Equestria by having Thorax come across other Changelings kidnapping Shining Armor, Princess Cadence, and Flurryheart, and how he ran off to run into Starlight and Trixie in the night. In Season 7, I don't see much changes within Triple Threat or to change a Changeling because it establishes Thorax's issues as the new leader. But I really wish we got these two ideas. An episode where Thorax takes his cute little Changeling protege Ocellus under his wing in the first place, and how he learns that Chrysalis might have done some manipulation on her that caused her to be nervous around others and shapeshift to hide her true self constantly. This'll showcase Thorax being like a nice mentor to Ocellus and is willing to keep her safe from any harm, and how this'll tie into the Season 8 premiere. And another episode with Thorax and his older brother Pharynx together and actually make a plot on the ironic irony that the two Changelings are like the two royal sisters in height and color schemes. I would dub this idea as a royal problem, the second part. Yeah, I know the name looks lame, but just the idea feels like a continuation to that episode in my eyes. Season 8 is where it hurts the most in terms of concept, and it is giving other races of Equestria more time to shine. And you think the Changelings can get more lore purpose, right? Right? Nope. The season is just filled to the brim of an underdeveloped school of friendship and the young six, all because the staff just want to butcher our main six ponies so badly. I'm not sure how to add more Thorax-related stories into Season 8, and also make it tied to the theme of it all, but certain fanfictions could have worked as an episode. One story example, called Hot Swap, could have been a great mix-up episode of Thorax and Ocellus switching places for a day before shenanigans ensues. Ocellus learns that shapeshifting is not the answer to a problem. Thorax really admitting that being in charge of the Changeling Hive can tire him out sometimes, and how this mistake strengthens their adorable student and teacher relationship to a genuine friendship that really could have been the next Twilight and Celestia, in my opinion. And another episode where Thorax happily congratulates Ocellus about her accomplishments at the School of Friendship, and discusses what her future might be, and this causes Ocellus to not want to rush to what she wants to do when she becomes a full-grown Changeling. These two episodes could have given focus to develop Ocellus to make her interesting in terms of her personality, flaws, and her interactions with Thorax, and how the two connect a friendship together. And then for Season 9, let him be crucial to the events that build up throughout the season. Have Chrysalis want to get her vengeance on not just Starlight Glimmer, but also Thorax himself for taking her position as leader of the Changelings. And give Thorax the freedom to use his horn to perform magic spells, because that is something that was never brought up again after the Season 6 finale, unfortunately. Thorax having a magical horn that shoots magic while having elements of being a royal being. My guess is that he is on the level of Alicorn magic in terms of performing magic. Maybe it's because he has the most love that he unleashed out. I can't be wrong on that, but since the show doesn't bother to expand on Thorax with how his appearance makes him the Celestia of the Changelings, and how his antlers glowing like his horn is so cool. During the ending of the end climax, Thorax and Pharynx could have performed to make a powerful energy beam together. Pharynx's magic aura will be red to contrast with Thorax's light blue magic aura. It's from the fan art that I keep on seeing so many times, so I'm just gonna call that Pharynx's magic aura is just red. Oh, and also expand how Thorax can feel sensitive with his emotions. There was a story that got deleted off the fanfiction website out of nowhere called A Fellow Leader's Issues, where it makes a continuation after the season 9 episode Uprooted, where Thorax scolds Ocellus for leaving the hive without telling anyone, making the hive start a panic. This story has this idea that could fit into Thorax's character, questioning his actions towards others and how he affects others' feelings. And it's understandable that Thorax goes through this kind of struggle when he scolds Ocellus. He reflects that if he is being a good ruler or took the reprimanding a bit too far, because we all see him as a really dorky but nice guy. Thorax has a conversation with Ember on how they haven't spoken to each other in a while, and how she might have rubbed her stern demeanor onto him in the season 8 premiere. Thorax and Ocellus reconcile at the end with a bit more time between the two and let this plot be a season 9 episode on its own. Like, have the actual plot of Uprooted, and then have the ending of the episode make it look like it would continue for the next episode. Like, make it a two-parter in a way like that. Like, make these two ideas into a two-parter. I know this story cannot be found anymore on the fanfiction website, but I still remember the story by heart, and I thought it would give another reason to have Thorax make an appearance in Season 9. Thorax as a character is one where the controversy about him is something I don't understand at all. Like Go from Pokemon Journeys, the hate from Thorax is bickering that I'll never understand, and continues supporting the character as a good one. But I can't ignore how the series gave him such little attention after his major appearances in Season 7. So I thought I could give Thorax more depth by giving out story ideas that could develop him to make some of the changes more natural and have his character be expanded upon to have certain characters to interact with, such as Spike, Starlight Glimmer, Pharynx, Ember, and Ocellus. And I know I might have found some of these ideas from stories I found on the fanfiction website, but the ones I mentioned could work within the canon of the show as normal episodes if they are handled correctly. Even though the show ended with Generation 5 taking on the air at the moment, Friendship is Magic will still be my favorite to talk about when it comes to certain topics. Thorax as a character has great potential to be something amazing, and the elements to make him great are there. But the show just doesn't expand on him more to make him one of the bigger deal-breaker characters in the series. So yeah, I know this video went on for long enough, but I really wanted to expand my comment on Tootsie's last MLP video about how Thorax could have had more depth in his purpose in the show. I hope you enjoyed this long discussion video about me rambling about how to fix the precious cinnamon roll Bug King, because I still stand to have Thorax be my favorite character of My Little Pony: Friendship is Magic.